Yo, what's up, guys? Keep Being Show here, and welcome to another video. Today we're gonna be giving my thoughts regarding the Super Mario Brothers Wonder Direct and some of the details that we spot during the direct, as we have a lot of stuff to go through regarding it, and I kind of just want to get my thoughts regarding the direct and seeing what I said. If you guys want to see my reaction towards it regarding the direct, I'm gonna leave it in the description down below for those who want to check it out. But otherwise, let's go ahead and kind of get my thoughts regarding it. So yeah, there's so much to go in with the Mario Brothers Wonder. There's a bunch of stuff that they put in regarding details and whatnot, and it's just crazy to believe, like I mentioned like a couple of days ago regarding the, like, my announcement regarding the direct, that we haven't had a game like this in a long time, like a 2D Mario game, and the fact that we have this now is kind of crazy. Has an interesting story, whatnot, a lot of characters pulled into it, with the powers being different and whatnot, and it's kind of weird because the plot, basically, Bowser has the flower and he basically transforms into this castle, which is kind of cool, and it's just kind of weird being that basically the plot and kind of taking over the Flower Kingdom, but it's kind of weird how that's just the plot, because normally the plot would be just, oh, Bowser rescues Peach, etc., etc. So they kind of went kind of with a different approach regarding it. So, but I'm a fan of it, because I'm not gonna lie, this is the little, like, sort of, I guess, plot of Bowser capturing Peach, etc., etc. It's kind of getting stale, kind of getting old. So the fact that we have this kind of, it's kind of cool. So the fact that, like, the plots are different and whatnot, it's pretty awesome. So yeah. This is Mario Bros. Wonder. The graphics look amazing. There's a bunch of characters which I'll showcase in a minute, but it's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. A bunch of cool levels. The fact that we have this, like, map, and it's supposed to be apparently like an open world area, it gives me so much gives me so much of Mario 3D World vibes. Because the way Mario 3D World, if y'all played it, obviously if you go to world map, you get to explore around a little bit and then enter the levels. But this gives me so much of that vibe. So the fact that we have this game and it kind of is like a world map sort of way is obviously pretty cool and whatnot, with the levels being somewhat difficult, like as you get through out of the stages and whatnot, which is like a normal Mario game. But just the way the open area is, as you see over here, it just looks really cool. Like I said, reminds me of 3D World so much, and it looks like it's different, like, areas regarding, like, the badges, regarding the areas, and you can skip through different areas if you like it, which is pretty good. We like to see that and whatnot. Some of these courses, like this course, looks pretty cool, like regarding, like, the different seasons being like spring, autumn and whatnot, and we got these talking flowers, which I did hear apparently you can turn them off regarding, like, them talking, so that's kind of cool. I'm most likely people are gonna do that considering the fact that you just try to play the game and not hear these flowers talk 24/7. So, but hey, that's cool though, at least. But yeah, so far it's pretty cool. And then you have the characters. Now there's a bunch of characters, which is actually kind of surprising. Obviously we have Mario, Luigi, Peach, Daisy, Yellowtoe, Bluetoe, Toadette, and some of the Yoshi colors, and Nabbit. Now, I do like these characters, I'm gonna be honest. I like the wide selection of characters, a lot of good characters. Probably the only problem I have with this regarding characters is that Yoshi is similar to Nabbit, where he can't take damage, but he also will transform into powers, which kind of sucks because Yoshi is one of my favorite Mario characters of all time. So the fact that he is basically an easy mode along with Nabbit kind of just, I really wasn't a fan of that per se. I wish he was just like a normal character, kind of like the other Mario characters, but it is what it is. But it's still kind of cool to see Yoshi in it, like, as an actual playable character instead of like a side character, but it's still cool. I was kind of surprised that Nabbit's also playable, because we didn't see him in the trailer like last time, so the fact that he's playable is kind of crazy. But other than that, I'm kind of cool with the character selection and whatnot. A really good wide selection of characters, and yeah, that's probably the only thing I have a problem with the character wide, but that's just like a small nitpick, considering the fact that Yoshi's one of my favorite characters, and the fact that he's kind of like, he's basically like Nabbit, kind of sucks. But I probably will still, maybe if I have the game, maybe I'll showcase him just to see what's up. along with his some other characters that you like. And Daisy's obviously playable, and she's new, which is kind of cool. So that's pretty sick. And yeah, just I'm like I said, characters I'm really excited for Loki. And Yoshi's base is similar to Nabbit, like I mentioned, where he can only die by getting hit by like lava, or by falling. And also he can grab stuff. The way, I'm not gonna lie, I'm gonna run this back real quick. The way Yoshi kind of eats this kind of is weird a little bit. Just the way his mouth is. I don't know. It just looks so weird when he grabs the items like that. But it still is kind of cool in a way. The animation alone, we also gonna talk about, is pretty spot on. It looks really good compared to like the old 2D Mario games and whatnot, along with the like new enemies and whatnot. But it's pretty. The animation looks really good. It just looks really good, honestly. I have nothing like bad to say about it. The animation looks pretty good. A lot of new enemies and whatnot to check out, just to see what they have and whatnot. It's pretty awesome to say the least. And a bunch of cool enemies. They also brought back a lot of items. The new items, actually, which real quick we'll talk about and whatnot. So go ahead and talk about the new items. You got a bunch of new items. You got the bubble, which is pretty cool. It's honestly pretty cool. It's a cool little addition. We got the drill, which is pretty cool. And obviously, who can't forget the new item that everyone likes, the elephant, which is it's kind of funny in a way. It's fun little item. Feel me? Transformation's kind of cool, and it actually is pretty cool to say at least. Like turns into a vine, grows up vine and whatnot, and you can hit enemies. It's pretty fun, like, and the designs of some of these look pretty cool, like Toad, and look at Peach. Peach's little design, it's kind of cute and kind of cool, and it's awesome. Like I mentioned, the bubble's pretty cool, and the drill's pretty cool. It's a little fun, another fun, like, sort of addition. And then we have the Wonder Flower, which is not really an item, but it's basically an effect regarding levels. So once you touch it, basically different effects happen, and you have like a certain amount of time regarding the effects, and it's kind of sick, to be honest. Like the wall, looks pretty cool. The little like going in the walls, space, like this is basically drugs. Like, look, I don't take drugs. I don't recommend anyone taking drugs, but yo, this low-key is pretty sick though. This is basically Mario taking drugs in some sort of way. Certain fact that all sorts of stuff is happening. You can transform to different stuff, like kind of like the return of the pea balloon. Y'all remember that? Goomba Mario, Mario can transform to anything. Like it's so much going on regarding the Wonder Seed, but I am so down with it, low-key, because it's fire. It's pretty fire, low-key. And then we have, I think it's the badges. Yes, the badges. So regarding the badges, it's basically, it's kind of hard to explain, but if you basically go to the rec, you obviously know what it is. But specific stuff, you get little advantages regarding badges. So regarding these badges, if you look over here, you can, it's different ones. I forgot how to unlock it, but regarding the badges, if you pick one, it gets like a certain amount of like advantage, I guess you just want to call it. So such as this one, like floating high jump, you get a jump higher. The little badge on the top left basically lets you have a parachute cap. It looks pretty cool. It's like a little gliding mechanic, wall jumps. It's a pretty cool, nifty little advantage. Little dolphin kicks, pretty cool. So much going on regarding this. I know a lot of speedrunners that's gonna love this game, because with all these like badges and whatnot, dude, this is gonna be a love game for speedrunners, because speedrunners like to run the game fast and want to beat the game quick and whatnot. And I have so much love for speedrunners and whatnot, but this game, golly, I can tell they're gonna have so much fun with it, because this game honestly. I can see it being, this could be like a love for speedrunners and whatnot, especially this badge, the Jet Run, dude, you know, crazy people are gonna be using that, badge, a whole different badges, which looks pretty cool. I'm so excited for it, and it's gonna be kind of interesting to see what they have regarding, the use of these. And of course, you have, like, badge challenge, the badge challenge, and whatnot. And also you can play with like a bunch of friends, and they kind of made it weird as you could play obviously multiplayer good, which I liked. But also you can kind of do online, which not really, but you can basically, if you are stuck on a level, if someone can have like a checkpoint or something, you can I guess go to that checkpoint. I guess that's how you want to say it. It's kind of hard to explain. Yeah, with these dandies or something like that. So I guess like maybe if it's a hard level, yeah, it's like a checkpoint basically. So that's kind of cool, and it shows the amount of badges on the little hearts every time someone like the amount of times people has used that checkpoint, which is pretty cool. And it's a cool little, you know, I'm saying, a little nifty thing and whatnot. Pretty amazing. And you also could do like friend races. You could play with friends like not only online but in like locally, which is pretty cool. But I think it's like a friend race now. Though this is cool, it's a friend race. I wonder if we could just play the game like separately. Like, can you play the game like without friend races? Like, can we just play the game normally online? Like in what you call it, like 3D World kind of. Who knows? I'm kind of just wondering that in a way. But it still is cool that they allow you multiplayer, and it just looks amazing. Really looking forward to it. I'm pretty beyond excited, and that's basically it. There's a lot to go through regarding this, but I'm really, really stoked about this regarding the mechanics and the game itself just looks so good. If I forgot anything, let me know. But oh yeah, also I didn't even notice this in this direct. If you go right here, look at that. Captain Toad is in this. That's actually kind of cool. I didn't even notice this until I saw someone's reaction to this, and they mentioned it was Captain Toad. That's so cool. I didn't even notice that. So Captain Toad kind of is gonna probably be like Odyssey, where he kind of just goes to a random place and kind of just chills there. But that's kind of cool. But other than that, I think that's about it. I really enjoyed this direct. I'm really looking forward to the game. Like, really looking forward to the game, because the game looks amazing. It just looks good, honestly. Like, I'm just looking forward to it, honestly. Really excited for it, really looking forward to it. I said it a billion times, but the game looks somewhat good, and I'm really excited about it. And also, there's a new Switch thing if you want to go for it, which kind of looks cool. I'm also kind of wondering how the voice actor for Mario, Luigi, and how is that gonna work? Because you know, Charles Martinet, he said he's not. He said he kind of is taking a break regarding his voice acting regarding Mario, Luigi, and all that stuff. So I wonder how his voice is. I did hear some of the voices in this game, and they honestly are pretty good. So, but we'll still have to. I'm still kind of have to see what it is. Kind of like Rick and Morty in a way, where the voice is kind of gonna be a little bit weird throughout the game, but. Still, I'll see what once the game comes out, what people are thinking about it. But that's basically it. That was my thoughts regarding it. Let me know what y'all think. And if y'all like this, you feel me, like, subscribe, do what you gotta do. Other than that, thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know your thoughts on this, and have a good rest of your day. Peace.